أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى كَلَّا لَئِن لَّمْ يَنْتَهِ لَنَسْفَعًا بِالنَّاصِيَةِ نَاصِيَةٍ كَاذِبَةٍ خَاطِئَةٍ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the forelock of Abu Jahl as lying and sinful. Now the question that is asked is, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not describe any other part of Abu Jahl's body as lying and sinful? The verse clearly indicates that the forelock, which is the upper part of the forehead, is responsible for traits such as truthfulness and lying.
For many years, they didn't know what this part of the brain did. So these had little to do with the control of the functions of the body. Now, the frontal lobes, here in the last 50 years, we've learned that these frontal lobes are concerned with some of the highest mental functions of animals and humans. And we've done various studies which show that they are concerned with these highest levels of our thinking. Surah, it reads, do you see one who forbids a servant of ours, God, when he turns to pray? Do you see if he who prays follows the guidance and enjoins righteousness? Do you see if he obstructs, rejects truth and turns away? Does he not know that God sees? Let him beware. If he desists not, we, that is God, will punish him upon his forehead, a lying, sinful forehead. And the word used in the last two verses, which means the forehead is in this statement, we believe refers to the frontal lobes of the brain. And I was asked, how could the forehead have anything to do with sinning and with lying and so on? And I suggested that it was related to this higher function. So that the act of lying is initiated by the mental activities in the frontal lobes. And its instructions are then carried out by other parts of the brain, which affect the speech organs, so that they can bring about these unlawful acts and so on. So that we believe then that sins are planned in the frontal lobes before they're carried out by the eyes, the hands, and the sexual organs.
فنريهم آياتنا في الآفاق وفي أنفسهم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق